Filipino tennis ace Alex Ayala is again the recipient of a $250,000 grant from the International Tennis Federation. The ITF program seeks to support players from developing tennis nations in their quest to compete in international events, including the Grand Slams. The 17-year-old Ayala, who has won three junior Grand Slam titles, told ABS-CBN News receiving the grant is motivating and she feels blessed to get it for the second year in a row. Filipino Paul Volter duplicates his national indoor record on his way to a bronze finish at the Mondo Classic in Sweden. Obiena cleared 5.91 meters in his three attempts, the Philippine record he first set last year. This is his third podium finish in a little over a week. He opened the 2023 season with a silver in Germany, then bagged gold in France days later. In the NBA, All-Star guard Kyrie Irving has reportedly asked the Brooklyn Nets for a trade less than a week before the deadline. That's after negotiations for a contract extension allegedly bogged down. Irving is in his fourth year with Brooklyn, but the past 2 years have been rocky. In November, he served an 8-game suspension over a social media post that shared a link to an anti-Semitic film. The 30-year-old had also missed much of last season for refusing to get vaccinated against COVID-19. Pasinaya 2023, seen as the largest annual multi-arts festival in the country, kicks off. Let's get the latest from Jeff Hernandez. Jeff, good afternoon. Jeff, hello.
Rico, hundreds of students, art lovers, theater enthusiasts, and artists flock here at the Cultural Center of the Philippines for the Pasinaya 2023 Open House Festival. This is the first time in 2 years that Pasinaya graced the grounds of the CCP due to the pandemic. Pasinaya is an activity of the CCP where participants can join different kinds of workshops like acting for theater, hip-hop dancing, painting, shop art, film screenings, storytelling, and many more. One of the many workshops that was attended by participants was the traditional comedy or moro-moro, which the organizer said they will continue to teach the students so as to keep the tradition alive. At 6 p.m. tonight, there will be a lantern parade at the CCP lawn area. According to CCP's Vice President and Creative Director Dennis Marasigan, there are 2,750 artists participating. Other workshops and performances are also happening now at 13 partner museums. The workshops will continue until later this afternoon, while tomorrow there will be more literary performances and workshops before they officially close the festival. Those who will not be able to attend here at the CCP can also watch live feeds of the different activities on CCP's social media accounts. Riga.
Thank you so much, Jeffrey Hernandez.